الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله عليه الصلاة والسلام وهو سيد الخلق وخاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين أما بعد يقول الله عز وجل يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون كما يقول الله عز وجل في كتابه يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا كما قال الله عز وجل يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما اللهم اجعلنا من الفائزين والتائبين أدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن ينصر إخواننا في غزة ويتقبل شهداءهم ويحقن دماءهم ويشفي مرضاهم وينصرهم على أعداء الله وأعدائهم وندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يوفق ما بيننا ويحب فيما بيننا ويجعلنا نصرة لهذا الدين. My dear respected brother, Friday to Friday, you know, it seemed like, you know, time gets closer. The call of the zaman is from the sign of the end of the earth. Like if you see Ramadan comes and quickly now Hajj is coming up, starting next month, I think in the beginning, the end of May. And subhanAllah, from Friday to Friday, it's like everything goes faster. But the unfortunate thing, many of us still are not contemplating and trying to reflect on our relationship with Allah and know our responsibility toward Allah and know our responsibility toward our family and communities and the Ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad. We focus on a small part of this, which is what business I'm going to do, how much money I'm going to make, how I'm going to pay my rent, how I'm going to do so many things, but you don't focus on how I'm going to enter Jannah. You don't focus how we, generally speaking, don't focus how we're going to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We lose the sense of direction. You read every day, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Every day you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you to Sirat al-Mustaqim, which is the straight path to Al-Jannah and to pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يقول بعض أهل العلم أيها الأحباب ما هو أمر الأمال وما هي غاية غايات عند المؤمن وما هو الذي ينبغي أن يشغل به تفكيره تمتلئ به مشاعره وإحساسه أنه شيء واحد غير الله عز وجل. My dear respected brothers and sisters, what is supposed to be your goal in this dunya? What's supposed to occupy your mind and your heart, as the scholar stated in this small short talk? It is pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your point of focus, it is pleasing Allah and nobody else. Do not please humanity in expense of the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which we do. Sometimes we please our friend, we please our wife, the wife pleases her husband, we please our children. And we know sometimes it's an expense of our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is extremely dangerous because our emotions and our empathy toward the one we love sometimes makes us deviate. But we must bring ourselves and our loved one to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We must make him understand that his dunya is not going to last forever. We have so many distractions today from YouTube, TikTok, name it, you know, so much distraction. You will pick up that phone and it might lead you to haram, looking at things that you're not supposed to look at. It is one thing you look at it to benefit yourself, to make you closer to Allah and make you serve humanity and your community. It's fine. We're trying to gain some knowledge that is pleasing to Allah. But when you spend hours and hours and hours on it, and many pictures pass by your eyes, and many actions that they are not pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you continue, what happened in that moment? Your heart gets used to looking at haram and thinking that haram action is the norm, which it is not. Doesn't matter what becomes the norm. We know what the norm is. You as a mu'min, you should know what the norm is. You should not accept any normalized behavior that is not the way what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us to do, and the way what is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it's out of the parameters what Allah has set for you. The scholar goes on to say, فمن توفيق الله تعالى للعبد الذي عرف ربه أن يكون همه واحد هو مرضات الله تعالى ولا تتحقق هذه الغاية إلا بتعلق القلب بالله وحده حينها سيبحث المؤمن عن كل ما يرضي الله يفعله ويبتعد عما كل ما يسخط الله ويرضاه. And here the scholar goes on to say, so to be successful by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to have this vision that you are pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that your heart has to be connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is Allah says in the Quran? أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. That you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continuously. It's not that when you make salat and you leave, that's it, Allah is forgotten. That is not how it's supposed to do. Supposed to be. Doesn't mean that Ramadan left and my ibadah and connection to Allah has stopped. You should build on it. That's how you build your iman. That's how you get closer to Allah. We're all going to make mistakes. But the love of Allah to us gives us the room to fix and repent and return to Him. إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ لِمَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. So unfortunately, we don't do that. We keep running. And running, and what you're running after, my dear brother and sister. What are you running after? Ask yourself this question. Allah has decreed your rizq. Allah has decreed your rizq 50,000 years before you were born. This has been in many books written. 50,000 years before you were born, you know, Allah had written your rizq. There are things that can change that, but it's not the moral of the khutbah today. What we wanted to achieve, brothers, is to help each other connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and bring our children to this wagon that we all connected to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also that you stay away from anything that you might think going to bring the wrath of Allah on you. We must help each other as a community. Help our families. And once we do that, we can bring others to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because they're going to see something beautiful. Look at how the mu'min live. Look at what the example of the Muslim family is. Look at the example of the Muslim children are. But we cannot achieve that until we connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال الله تعالى وما لأحد عنده من نعمة تجزى إلا ابتغاء وجه ربه الأعلى ولسوف يرضى. Allah is very clear in this message, in this ayah. The name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that award you, that means you always seek Allah Almighty. And you have to be pleased, you know, pleased with Allah has decreed. You know, when you read the Quran, does not talk about happiness. Talk about that you're content. النفس المطمئنة. أنا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب. Does not say happy قلوب. الطمأنينة gives you contentment. Makes you relax. Makes you say whatever happened. And the example of our brother sister in Gaza made many people come to Islam. Not that we are here next to them. We haven't done a good job. Let us be honest. All of us, we failed to do that. But people are looking at what happened in Gaza and somebody saying, Alhamdulillah. Losing his property, losing his building, losing his children. And this person who's looking, say, what is this person saying? Why is he saying that? What does he have that I don't have? Many people find emptiness in their heart and they run to the psychologist and psychiatrist, which it's okay if you have chemical imbalance and you're struggling. But when you find an emptiness, that means some a void in your heart, that means your connection to Allah is not there. Your connection to Allah is not there. How do I do that? I connect with my community. Do not belittle your community, regardless of the fault they do. Do not push away the community and isolate yourself. The shaitan will take you down. Connect to your community. It has so much good in it. Regardless of the fault, we all have faults. We're not perfect. But you must connect to your community through the masjid, through activities, creative activities, doing this. And this is to benefit yourself, your family, and your children and others. And look at us, we live here, and that's it, we forgot until next Jummah. SubhanAllah. So how you want your children to learn the deen if you disconnected. I know we work hard in America, makes you work 12, 14, 16 hours, but you have to reconfigure the way how you do things. Because if you lose your children that you lost, you know, the akhirah. You can win in this dunya, but you lose the akhirah, that is not a win. وَمَنْ يُطَيَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. من سنن ابن ماجه عن عبد الله بن مسعود ان المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم سيدنا محمد قال: من جعل الهموم هما واحدا هم اخرته كفاه الله هم دنياه، ومن تشعبت به الهموم في احوال الدنيا تفرقت وكثرت لم يبال الله في اوديتهما هلك. So سبحان الله, it is very clear when you make your priority this dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala led you to it. It will take you apart. It will confuse you. Make you live, you know, in a struggle and in a misery. But when you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah puts sakinati in your heart. Bring comfort to you. Makes you so comfortable. Because you don't worry about tomorrow. That is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's extremely important. I am not saying, my brothers and sisters, we should not try to be successful and make money. What is the purpose of making money if you don't spend it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What is the purpose of the money if you don't show the ni'mah of Allah on you and you live miserable? And you're buying properties all over the world, but you don't even live in them. You're not even get to enjoy them, and some people will die here, and people have to raise money for them to bury them in Stafford. You must think, what is the priority of this money? You want a benefit of this money, and you spend it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You make a difference in humanity by spending that money because Allah has given it to you. وَانْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Allah gives you a command to spend. As I shared last week, a sister spent here the whole month praying with us. When our beloved Sheikh Mood was raising funds during the last 10 days, a sister raised her hand, she pinched her and said, put your money down, don't give them money. I feel so sorry for her. Look at now, you did the same battle for the whole month. And what you did, بِكَلِمَةٍ لَا تُبْكِي لَهَا بَالٍ تَهْوِي فِي جَهَنَّمَ سَبْعِينَ خَلِيفًا. One word you say, and you don't pay attention to it, you get thrown in hellfire 70 khalif, that means 70 years. Well, I would have been that. So the words we take out, the way how we think, it makes a difference. So look at now, a brother or sister does this. When he's standing asking Allah during the last 10 days, asking Allah for help, asking Allah to give him, asking Allah to do all these things. And then he might walk to the parking lot and do ghibah and namimah against the brother, and everything was taken away. Everything was taken away. And we all know the Prophet, Hadith sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-Muflis, the bankrupt person who came the day of judgment with so many hasanat, a mountain of hasanat. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, throw him in nari jahannam. Because none of it first was the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second one, what happened is that he has cursed this and spoke ill about this and cheated this. And Allah takes of the best of your hasanat. Let's say you went to Hajj. Let's say you built an orphanage. Let's say you built a masjid. Allah takes away from you those first. Then you start giving the change from the hasanat. And then when you don't have anything left, you take from the sayyat. At the end, you throw in nar jahannam wa na'udhu billah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us and make us understand what He's telling us, which is Allah is on the Prophet. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. كما يقول هذا العالم، وما جعل همه الدنيا، همه المال، همه المنصب، همه الشهرة، همه الشهوة، ضاق صدره وخاب سعيه وفقد نفسه وخسر دينه ودنياه. When you're looking for fame, just look at Hollywood, for example. How many of them die on drug overdose? With all the money and the fame he gets. So many of our children are looking at that as a model, as an example. Which our best example is our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For our daughters to look at Ummat al-Mu'mineen, say, Aisha radiallahu anha, أمنا خديجة رضي الله عنها and so on and so forth and صحابيات. That is the example. But we fail to make our children understand the value they have. So if you're looking for the value of being famous, being influential, fame, making money, all those things, there is no value to Allah in that. If this life were to work, جناح بعوضة, the wing of a بعوضة, of a حشرة, of an insect. Allah would not give it to people who do not believe in the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But iman only been given to Allah who He loves and people who seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what happened, your heart gets tight because you always envy to another person who might, you might see him, that Allah elevated him.
Allah elevates people, Allah drops people. So this person, Allah give him, you know what? Hikmah, make him likable, make him, you know, a leader, make him because he sees something in him. Even that person might not realize. And the person who's seeking fame and all this has so much jealousy against that person who wants to take him down at any cost. Because in his heart there is tightness, because he's seeking fame, he's seeking wealth, he's seeking position, he's seeking. And that person that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves is elevating him. That's the way how Allah wants, and there is nobody who would want to take him down. As I said many times, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَلِيُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. So fix your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كما قال هذا العلم ويتخذ كل وسيلة توصله لذلك من رسوخ العقيدة وإحسان العبادة ودعوة إلى الله وتربية الأولاد على الإسلام ومناصحة أهل الحق ومناصرة المستضعفين ومعادة المجرمين وهداية الضالين وعزة المسلمين والانضباط في الحياة على منهج الله والعمل لدخول الجنة والنجاة من النار. So when you make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is your priority. Allah should be our priority. You must ask yourself, what is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your agenda? Write down what is your first priority, and what is your second priority, what is your third, and see where Allah fits. And that's how you know your relationship with Allah. If Allah is the first, then hammuka Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah is second, third, fourth, and you put him in your priority, then hammuka laysa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we need to go back and fix our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لذلك ما أجمل أن يجعل العبد حياته لله فإن عبدا فلله فإن عبد فلله وإن كتب فلله وإن تعلم فلله وإن خطب فلله وإن تزوج فلله وإن جمع المال فهو لله فالهم واحد مرضاة الله وطرق الخير إليه كثيرا متنوعا. قال تعالى والذين جاهدوا فينا لنهدينهم سبلنا وإن الله لمع المحسنين. So when you make your life, everything you do. The problem we have today, let's just jump to marriage. What is the reason we have so many problems in marriage? What's the reason that we have a wife and put on her husband and accuse him wrongfully and send him to jail? He might be facing 11, 12, 15 years. Or put him in jail because she wants to get divorced. And this is all over the world. Because the foundation that the Prophet ﷺ said for you is to marry. The fourth one, it is to please Allah, that's your deen. And when somebody comes to you as a man that has deen and khuluq, you don't look at his, oh, you're a doctor, then I'm going to marry my daughter. You're an engineer, how much money you make? It's like now we're selling cows in the market. When somebody comes to you and has the value of the man of honor, the man that fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give him your daughter. You make excuses, you're looking for something again to please others. This marriage is not pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is pleasing others. It is seeking fame, it's seeking whatever, you know, is disconnected from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we must return to the way of Allah. We must create value in our community so our children can marry each other and get to know each other, and the parents get to know each other. And we always must be honest with each other. That is the value of this deen. And we must love each other for the sake of Allah. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this hadith of Qudsi قال يَبْنَ الْآدَمْ خَلَقُ السَّمَاوَةَ السَّبْعُ وَأَوَالِ السَّبْعُ وَلَمْ أَعْيَى بِخَلْقِهِنَّ أَيُّهِينِ رَغِيفٌ يَعِيشٍ أَسُوقُهُ لَكَ بِلَا تَعَالَ يَبْنَ الْآدَمْ إِنَّهُ لَمْ أَنْسَ مَنْ عَصَانِي فَكَيْفَ مَنْ أَطَاعَنِي وَأَنَا رَبٌّ رَحِيمٌ وَعَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying this hadith Qudsi has created the earth and the seven heavens. And it did not make him tired. So how is your living, your sustenance going to make Allah tired? With his khazain la tunfad, his wealth, everything never diminishes. It's like you take a needle and you put it in the sea. Do you take anything out of the sea? This is khazain Allah. So why are we, you know, we hate each other? Why are we doing this? Why I settle you up for failure? Why I have to be jealous of you? Why I don't help you all come to the wagon? Jump on a train all together. Because innama al-mu'minuna ikhwah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on to say, Yadna Adam, innahu lam ansa man asani. That means whoever disobeyed Allah and returned to him, Allah forgives him. فَكَيْفَ مَنْ أَطَعَنِي وَأَنَا رَبُّنْ رَحِيمٌ وَعَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. How is it when somebody obeys Allah and I am very merciful and capable of doing whatever I please? So do not hate, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy, it's so great. Do not despair. When you mess up and you commit a sin, we all do and we all shall do. Return to Allah. Run to the masjid, run to a place. Make shurukat, make wudu, you know, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make sujood and cry to Him. Allah loves the mu'min who comes to Him. He opens his arm. So we must return to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not become reality except by obeying Allah and Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma hdina fi min hadayt, wa ghafirna fi ma ataytu, wa qina sharra min hadayt. اللهم اهدنا واهدنا اللهم اهدنا واهدنا اللهم اهدنا واهدنا اللهم الله جعلنا قلوبنا اللهم اهد اهل هذا البلد الاسلام وحبب اليهم الاسلام والمسلمين واجعلنا نكون قدوة لهم. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وارحم امواتنا واشف مرضانا واحفظ ابنائنا وبناتنا وازواجنا. اللهم احفظنا من كل سوء. اللهم من اراد بالمؤمنين خيرا اللهم وفقه اليه ومن اراد بهم سوءا اللهم اجعل دائره السوء عليه. اللهم يا رب ارحم الراحمين ارينا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه والباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك الحرام وارزقنا بفضلك عمن سواك. اللهم الف بين قلوبنا وحبب من بيننا واجعلنا ننصر اخواننا في غزه. اللهم انصرهم وتقبل شهداءهم واحقن دماءهم واشف مرضاهم واحفظهم من كل سوء وانصرهم على اعدائهم. واسال الله سبحانه وتعالى to make us among the righteous, unite our heart. Make us love each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek Allah protection. We seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we ask Him to open our heart to love Him and love our brothers and sisters and make us sincere in our love to Him, love to our beloved Prophet, and love to our communities and our brothers and sisters. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect our wives, our children, and our daughters and make Him see what is right. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put barakah in our life and our children, and our money, and our wealth and make us to serve His mission and make us an example to others to the way of Allah. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. صلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وآخر الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله. استقيموا
الحمد لله وشاءوا صلاتكم ودعوا لأنفسكم إخواننا في كل مكان خاصة في السجود. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم ملك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. اللهم سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم ملك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله Can you please press the boxes, please, brother? Please don't generous donation, please generous part of our people. Where the last panel that said for us, we do have a variety program for adults of Arab that he wants to start, and it will be Monday and Thursday. You can see him. You know, and talk to him, who can call me, inshallah. And we have, you know, the youth program, right, has been going on for a while now, and that's Wednesday and Sunday. And also we have a program for girls, 13 to 16, about conflict and expressing their emotion, and this is done by a life coach, alhamdulillah, for 8 weeks. It just started last week. If you want to register your kids for next year for the program during the week, or Tahfidh Quran, see the brother, the sister that you're in charge of the school. Barakallahu alaikum. Anybody wants to get involved and bring in a program, please do. Bring some programs so we can, you know, activate and make sure that our children come to the masajid. You know, Barakallahu alaikum. Uhibbukum fillah. Wassalamu alaikum. ما كاين شي حاجه تما كان